In this video, I'm going to talk about passive range of motion of the hip joint. When you observe limited range of motion during active testing, it is wise to do passive range of motion. The goal of passive range of motion is to get information on the so-called end feel. There are several kinds of end feels. Take a look at this table to learn about their characteristics. When conducting passive range of motion, it is crucial to fixate surrounding structures that might induce compensatory movements. For flexion, grab the leg, instruct your patient to relax, bring it into end range, and assess the end feel. For extension, you have two options to fixate. First, there's the ischial tuberosity, and secondly, there's the sacrum. Be aware that if you choose for the sacrum as your point of fixation, that the SI joint will be moving with, and you will have increased range of motion versus fixation at the ischial tuberosity. For extension, grab your patient's leg, choose your point of fixation, make sure your fixation is properly, and move into extension. To conduct passive range of motion in the direction of abduction, make sure to support the leg and to keep it straight to prevent any rotation in the hip while doing abduction, and also fixate the pelvis. I like to choose for fixation on the opposite iliac crest and then move the leg outwards as far as possible. To conduct passive range of motion in the direction of adduction, ask your patient to cross one leg over the other. Then you want to pick up the other leg. Fixate, I like to choose the opposite iliac crest, and move into adduction as far as possible. To assess internal rotation of the hip, grab your patient's leg, flex the hip to about 90 degrees, and then bring the heel outwards as far as possible. To assess external rotation of the hip, grab your patient's leg, flex it to about 90 degrees, and bring the heel inwards as far as possible. All right, this was our video on passive range of motion of the hip joint. I hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up as always. Make sure to subscribe to our channel if you haven't. This was Andreas for PhysioTutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.